Hello everyone, welcome along to another one of our quality videos from the King Edmund School Science channel.
Don't forget to like and subscribe, make sure you get all the notifications, so click the link down the bottom, okay, and the bell so you get notifications.
Enjoy!
Good afternoon, ladies and gents. So I've got a question here from C7, which is about fractional distillation. So this is in the topic all about hydrocarbons, about crude oil. So this is a really, really common question. So normally it's a 4 marker or a 6 marker. So we're going to go through the key points that you're going to need to talk about. So most of the compounds in crude oil are hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons with the smallest molecules are very volatile. The word volatile means how easy they evaporate. Okay, so that's not to be confused with viscosity, which is kind of how gloopy they are. So different words there. Okay, so in this question you will be assessed on using good English, organizing information clearly, and using specialist terms. So the key thing here really is specialist terms, so don't worry too much about your spelling. As long as it's kind of readable phonetically, it makes sense, don't panic. So you can also use little bullet points to separate your ideas as well. That's not going to lose you any marks as long as you are writing a proper sentence with a full stop and a capital letter. So we're going to describe and explain how petrol is separated from the mixture of hydrocarbons in crude oil. So we've got crude oil going here. This is the mixture. There's loads of different chain lengths in here. Now what we're going to be looking for is petrol to be coming off on one of these pipes here. Now you don't need to worry about what the other ones are, it's just asking us about petrol. So we're going to use the diagram and our knowledge to answer this question. So the first thing that happens, so we're going to describe the process. So remember, describing is a series of steps in order. Okay, so describe. First of all, the crude oil was heated. Okay, and we're going to explain then, okay, at the same time. So the crude oil is heated because it needs to evaporate or vaporize. Okay, second idea then. We've got, that's actually 2 points in one, sorry guys. So we've got vaporizer as a mark and then heating it as a mark. Okay, right, so on to our third mark then. We're going to talk about this column. Okay, we're going to refer to the picture. So it is very hot at the bottom. Very hot at the bottom and it is cooler at the top. Okay, so we're going to talk about that. So you can say column. So the columns are hotter at the bottom. Right, so now at the moment we've got all of our kind of crude oil coming in, so we can imagine it's all vapors. Some of it won't turn into a vapor, and that's the bitumen. This is the bit that is really kind of gloopy. It stays as a liquid. It's got a very high melting boiling point, sorry, so it won't even evaporate. So at the moment we've got this kind of vapor. It's going to travel up the column, so it's going to travel up to where it's cooler. So the vapors are going to condense, so vapors rise okay, they're going to rise up the column and they are going to condense, and they're going to condense when they reach their boiling point. Okay, so it sounds funny because I'm saying boiling and they're already gases, but boiling and condensation will happen at the same temperature. So it just depends if you're going up to the boiling point or if you're coming down to the boiling point. So they're going to rise up the column and condense at their boiling point. So the key thing to remember then is that the cooler at the top is going to be where your small molecules are going to evaporate, condense. So small chains condense at lower boiling points near the top, because remember the top is colder, that's a lower temperature, and then the long chains condense at the higher temperatures nearer the bottom, because remember the bottom is hot. Okay, so they're going to be condensing at different points, and they're going to be coming out of these pipes and separating off into the different fractions. So fractions, petrol is an example of a fraction. Okay, higher temperatures, sorry, I didn't finish that sentence. Long sentences, long chains condense at the higher temperatures near the bottom. And that's it. So important things to remember, words. So heating, vaporizing, the word condensing, the word condensing again, and then temperature. So you want to refer to the high temperature and to the low temperature. Okay, I hope that's helped. Good luck.